In this video, I would like to show you the effects, possibilities and constraints of outdoor mobility on healthy and active aging. Outdoor mobility can be defined as the possibilities to move around, out of the home. Being out there on the street has many positive aspects which influence the physical, the mental and social well-being of seniors. Moving around in the public domain influences the physical state of the body directly. The spatial environment gives all kinds of physical stimuli and incentives to people to walk, to accelerate and decelerate, to cycle, to enter a vehicle, sitting down, standing up, climbing stairs, to balance one's body while moving. They are all simple physical activities which come with outdoor mobility and which keep the human body fit. They trigger all kinds of human body systems, such as the cardiovascular system and one's muscles, but also your senses, smelling, feeling, touching, seeing and hearing. But moving around also influences the mental state of the body directly. The spatial environment gives all kinds of mental incentives to people to plan a trip, to know your way, to understand the timetable, to understand a ticket machine, to make assessments about the traffic situation, to adapt your traffic behavior, for example your speed, to other traffic participants. Going outdoors stimulates all kinds of neuropsychological and neurophysical processes. And additionally, outdoor mobility also stimulates one's social health. Having the possibilities to go out stimulates to actively visit one's family, friends, the sports club, the shopping center, the library, a museum, to go on holidays, to do voluntary work. So, outdoor mobility facilitates people to participate in society. And this prevents elderly, for example, from feeling lonely, one of the heaviest burdens which come with aging, when people close to you fall away. Quite logically, a shrinking social network decreases the reasons for seniors to go out, decreasing the amount of time being spent outdoors and thus decreasing the number of physical and mental incentives which keep people more fit. So, in summary, there clearly is a positive spiral of elderly being fit physically, mentally and socially, who go outdoors, who get their stimuli and incentives mentally, physically and socially, which keeps them fit physically, mentally and socially, which makes them go out more, and so on. But of course, also the other way around. Elderly who are less fit physically, mentally or socially, go out less, get less stimuli and incentives, which makes them less fit, which makes them go out less, and so on. Within the European MobileAge research program on the outdoor mobility of people in later life in the early 2000s, we developed a valuable and very much needed integral perspective on the health of people, physical, mental, social health, and on the role of the outdoor mobility of people on their health. Health scientists, psychologists, sociologists, gerontologists, urban planners and traffic planners together interviewed more than 3,000 European seniors living in Finland, Germany, Hungary, Italy and the Netherlands, and evaluated their daily outdoor activity travel patterns and their personal satisfaction with their mobility in both urban and rural conditions. What became very clear from the MobileAge research project is that there is not something like the elderly. It's a very large and growing group of people with numerous and various mobility wishes, needs, demands and expectations for their activity travel behavior. There are so-called mobility-rich elderly enjoying a very mobile lifestyle, so-called mobility-poor elderly who face many, many mobility challenges in their lives and everything in between. And the different European societal, cultural and spatial conditions influence this variety directly. We, among others, asked all seniors about their wishes to improve transport and travel possibilities. Of course, they came up with all kinds of hard financial, functional and physical suggestions, as you can see in the table. But most interestingly, the top one score was a soft improvement, the wish for more road courtesy. It goes without saying that independence, self-reliance and autonomy are the fundamentals of active and healthy aging, also from a mobility point of view. It is wished for by the seniors themselves, they told us in the MobileAge interviews, but also by society. Both the transport possibilities and the planning of the city are crucially important to stimulate the positive spiral mentioned earlier. And elderly like to move around independently, by foot, by bike, by car. Sometimes people think that public transport is the perfectly suited for elderly, but unfortunately, it's nothing like that. First, it is slower and or less direct than individual modes of transport. But second, one also needs to be mega fit, physically and mentally, to understand and use the public transport system, to buy a ticket at the machine, or to change one's public transport card, to charge one's public transport card, to check in and out, to understand the floor plan of a station, to run for catching a bus, to walk the stairs in stations, to transfer from access mode of transport to the main mode of transport to the egress mode of transport. Public transport can be a real physical and mental challenge for vulnerable people. Then, how do seniors choose how to move around? In the field of activity travel behavior, three levels of behavioral choices are distinguished. First, long-term choices, like where do I choose to live? In what kind of house? In what kind of neighborhood? In which city? For example, in relation to where one's children or grandchildren live. Second, midterm choices, like do I buy a car, an e-bike, or a public transport annual card? Or what shopping centers do I consider for doing my grocery shopping? And third, daily choices, like what mode of transport do I use today? Which route do I take? We know that for elderly, walking is the basic mode of transport. So the physical distances to potential activity places in the city are crucially important for seniors, and in particular for those with a decreasing action space. Consequently, for spatial planners and traffic planners, it is important to understand that urban facilities should be available at walking distances, that the location of dwellings need to be understood and planned in relation to those urban facilities, for example, shopping centers, but also that the city, and in particular the public space, need to be planned and designed according to the wishes of pedestrians. The other videos will tell you more about this topic. Old age comes with ailments. The Mobilate research shows us that elderly develop all kinds of personal coping strategies. For example, they avoid certain conditions, environments or circumstances in which they do not feel at ease, such as bad weather conditions like rain, or peak hour traffic. Or they make use of certain technologies which make their life easier, for example, with respect to endurance. Here you see a Dutch example of e-bikes, which can be rented at railway stations. Or with respect to physical mobility, a low entry-level bike. Or anxiety about not knowing the way, route planners. User-friendly technologies help the seniors of today and even more the seniors of tomorrow in their outdoor mobility. Healthy aging is active aging.